Welcome! In this video, I'll demonstrate how to use the EvilInnocence Fairy Magic utility to add sparkles to your poser scenes. For this tutorial, I'm going to use the Ninja Sprite character, which I already have loaded here in Poser. Since Fairy Magic only works on object files, the first thing to do is to export the Ninja Sprite character from Poser. I'm exporting the Ninja Sprite character along with her hair and her wings so that we can put sparkles around everything. I'm also using the default settings, since it doesn't really matter how we export the object. Once the object is exported, we can open the Fairy Magic utility and load the object. Next, we choose the settings for our sparkle objects. For this one, I'll be using the Sparkle 3 object, which is just a set of interlocking planes. You also have several other ones that you could use if you want to, from spheres to boxes and other shapes. I'm also increasing the number of particles to 600, so we have a few more around the Ninja Sprite. There will be three material zones on the sparkles, which will be randomly assigned to all of the particles. Clicking the Create Prop checkbox will create a prop so you can load it directly in Poser without having to import the geometry. I'm also increasing the scale of the objects so that they're a little bit bigger, and increasing the distance so they're a little bit farther away from the Ninja Sprite. Once the options are set to your liking, click on the Add Magic button to create the sparkles. This will create the sparkles in the background, and it may take several seconds to run. The more particles you use and the larger the base object is, the longer it will take to run. Once the sparkles are generated, the utility will ask you where you want to save the object. Then, if you chose to create a prop, it will ask you where you want to save the prop file. This should be saved in a Poser runtime directory so that Poser can load it. Then, we can go back into Poser and load the prop. This will bring in the sparkle objects and place them around the base object. Even though the base object in this case is a figure, the sparkles themselves are just a prop, so they won't pose with the figure. The last thing to do is to add materials to the sparkle object. The sparkle template I used in this case is a set of crisscrossing planes, so I used one of the transparency maps that came with Fairy Magic to give the sparkles a rounder shape. I also assigned a high value to the ambient color channels so that the sparkles will appear to glow if you use Poser's indirect illumination. And there you go. Now that everything's set up, you can render the scene and see the Ninja Sprite surrounded with sparkles.